one. The national capital is grappling with a sharp rise in vector-borne disease cases, with recent data painting a concerning picture for residents and authorities alike. According to the vector-borne diseases report of the MCD, Delhi has registered 4,533 dengue cases and 3 deaths from the beginning of the year. Now, key areas contributing to the dengue spike include Najafgarh, South Delhi, Shahdra, Karol Bagh, and Central Delhi. Let me take that straight across to Isha, who continues to stay with us. Isha, on one hand, you have a double whammy with the air and water pollution. And when you're talking about health over here now in specific, it's a triple threat, because we're, you know, looking at an aspect where this is a clear uptick in cases, which is concerning. But more importantly, what directives, you know, have been given in that order? How are they combating the situation? And we're given to understand there is a little bit of a decline in dengue cases, but that still means there are health concerns for people living in the Delhi region.
Right, Nivedana. In fact, it's a triple whammy for the people in the national capital, because with the onset of the winter season, after the monsoons, cases and the vector-borne diseases have also gone up, which does include dengue, chikungunya and malaria. The total number of dengue cases is about 4,553 at the moment, but there's still a month and a half to go, and it is all set to cross the 6,000 mark. In fact, the major problem that the MCD is grappling with right now is not able to maintain cleanliness across places in the national capital. And there is a lot of garbage collection issues that is also taking place because of the alleged mismanagement inside the MCD. So that is a problem that is taking place. And there was, of course, the national capital was a mess during the monsoon season. We all saw how easily the national capital would get flooded within 5 minutes as it would start raining. And again, that was the mismanagement of the Delhi government, the MCD. They were all caught at the back foot yet again. But even after that, the vector-borne cases have only gone up. In fact, now the testing is also ramping up. But these cases are continuously going up in the coming days as well. In fact, fumigation of houses is also now taking place. In fact, the MCD has also allotted a particular amount of money to every ward to make sure that that all fumigation processes are complete and that every ward can actually maintain cleanliness in proper fashion. But despite that, the people in the national capital continue to suffer. The safety conditions are also extremely bad. Health is something that has gotten extremely poor, because from every side there is a problem, be it air quality, be it vector-borne diseases, be it cleanliness. It's more than a triple whammy.
Isha, like as you point that out, and I'm sure, you know, being a resident of Delhi region as well, and what you're really looking at unfold, you know, it's quite alarming to say the least. You can't have proper air to breathe. Your water is polluted. Now you have health diseases. It doesn't really matter what age group you're in. It really seems like there's no accountability, number one, like we were speaking about. More importantly, it seems as if this is not even an important solution or a problem that needs to be looked into.
Absolutely, Nivedana. In fact, nobody's actually spoken about it as well. In fact, this happens every year. We have this conversation every year. We were having this conversation last year. We're having this conversation this year. And we will continue to have this conversation because the state of the national capital refuses to change. The Aam Aadmi Party has been in power for the last 10 years. The MCD and the Delhi government both are under the Aam Aadmi Party. So they can't now state that, oh, the MCD is not under us, so we can't give them complete orders. The national capital is completely under the Aam Aadmi Party. It is their helm. It is completely their rule, and despite that, there is such less accountability. In fact, Gopal Rai, the environment minister, comes out every year, does a press conference about pollution, says that we're monitoring it, crackers are banned, and we'll make sure that pollution is less. But again, then the politics over it peaks. BJP, Congress both jump in, calling the Aam Aadmi Party out. But the Aam Aadmi Party then gets involved in dealing with that criticism rather than actually dealing with the problem at hand. In fact, the Yamuna crisis has also been has also shown the ugly side of the national capital to the world, because there was Chhat Puja that was being organized. And despite that, we saw that the toxic form had completely engulfed that area and no corrective action was taking place unless there was actually a lot of pressure being put by the media, being put by the opposition. Before that, the Aam Aadmi Party refused to take any accountability.